Okay, so this video is going to show you how to attach more than one picture when you're sending an email using Gmail. So first thing you want to do is go to Safari, open it up. You want to go to your, however you log into Gmail. Pick which account. Once you got your account, sign into it. So when you go to compose a new email, you're going to click this compose button on the left. And this is just showing you that this is their new way of sending an email. You can just click OK, you got it, because you know how to do it. So when you send it to whoever, you're going to put in their email address. I'll just email it to myself. Pictures. Okay, so then you're gonna go down here to this little thing that looks like a paper clip. Click it, and then wherever on your computer where your pictures are, you're gonna go to that folder. So I'm already in my pictures folder. Say you've entered a memory card into your computer, it's gonna pop up right here, and it'll say whatever that name of the memory card is. You would select it, you'd see which pictures you want. So you got these. So if you know you want these four in a row, you can just click and hold the button down and drag your mouse and select them. Say you don't want to get these next three, but you want to get the fourth one. Hold down the command key. It's to the left of the space bar, and then just keep holding command and just letting go and clicking on the mouse on each picture that you want. And as long as you hold command down, it's just gonna select whatever you pick. And right now I'm just right clicking on the mouse one time each time. So Gmail does have a limit. You can only send 25 megabytes at a time. So these pictures are kind of big. So I could probably only send about three of them. So I'll just send these ones. Once I've selected the ones I want, click choose. And there it is. It starts loading them into your email. And you can click send before it's done loading. Even though this screen went away, it's still uploading the pictures into the email. So you just don't want to turn your computer off until it's done. And it gives you an update up here. It shows you what's going on.